Welcome to this edition of Burn Tech University presented by Breckwell. In today's video, we'll show you how to properly replace the igniter in your SP2000 pellet stove.
Always refer to your owner's manual. This video is for informational purposes only. If you are unsure about replacing any of the components on the stove, we recommend having a certified electrician or stove technician do this for you.
Project are a 7/16 inch socket driver, a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, and a 1/8 inch Allen wrench. Before starting our project, first make sure your stove is completely cool and then remove the power cord from the back of your stove. Now, using your number 2 Phillips screwdriver, loosen the screws holding the back of the stove in place. You do not need to fully remove these screws. Once these screws are loose, you can easily lift the back of the stove up and away from the stove, being sure to set it aside from your work area. Next, locate and unplug the two wire leads coming from the auger motor that attach the wiring harness. Next, locate the retainer clip holding the auger motor to the auger drive shaft. While supporting the auger motor with one hand, use your needle nose pliers to remove the retainer clip. The auger motor should then drop down free from the auger drive shaft. Now that we've removed the auger motor, locate the two wire leads leading from the igniter module and unplug them from the wiring harness. Now, using your nut driver, remove the two bolts that hold the igniter module in place. Once the bolts are removed, the igniter module and igniter housing will easily slide free from the stove. Then, using your Allen wrench, loosen the set screw on the back of the igniter module. This will allow the igniter module to slide free from the housing. Now, take your new igniter module and insert it into the igniter housing. Leave approximately 1/4 inch from the end of the housing to the tip of the igniter module. Then, tighten your set screw back up to hold the igniter in place. Then, insert the igniter housing and the igniter module back into its proper hole in the back side of the stove. Replace the two bolts and tighten securely with your nut driver. Once secure, be sure to reconnect the two wire leads from the igniter back to the wiring harness. To install the auger motor, simply place it between the two flanges, line up the hole in the auger shaft, and insert the retaining clip. Once the retaining clip is secure and the auger motor is in place, reconnect the two wire leads to the wiring harness. Now, to put the stove back together, simply set the back of the stove over the screws and slide it down into the slot. Then, using your number 2 Phillips screwdriver, secure the back to the stove.
Once again, this video is for informational purposes only. We strongly recommend a certified electrician or stove technician do any repairs for you.
Now that you successfully completed your repair and replaced the back of the stove, be sure to plug your stove back in and check for proper operation. Should you have any further questions, please visit our website at www.breckwell.com or contact our customer service toll-free at 1-866-606-8444. Thank you for watching Burn Tech University.